Hi guys, welcome to Making Australia the Crafty Show, where we're going to be recapping every episode of Making Australia. I'm crochet artist Julie Philly, and every week I'm joined by a new fun crafty guest. And this week I'm joined by designer, crafty designer behind Doodad and Fandango, Nikita Majajas.
Woo! Hi Phil, hi Julie, how are you going?
You obviously have a lot of your work behind you. For those who've never seen your work before, how would you describe it?
Well, I work mostly in acrylics and laminates, and I make jewellery, decor, art, lots of wearable objects. But I'm mostly staying in the realm of working with acrylics, bright and colourful acrylics.
So the theme of this episode is all about sort of dreams and executing your dreams and all that sort of thing. And so for the faster craft, the makers were asked to create a piggy bank that was the physical object was sort of the goal, I guess. So we did see a lot of houses. Who was your favourite piggy bank?
Oh, well, I loved George's, actually, the winning one. I did love elements of everybody's, like I always do. I love Rahana's, the dreaminess. I love the balloon floating upwards to as your dreams were achieved. And I related to how, was it three out of the four creators were saving up for a house? I mean, what an Australian story, you know? And as creatives, it can feel like that dream is so far away.
Yes.
You know,
especially these days.
is it even achievable? But I really did love George. And it was funny when Benja, the judge, was going around and he said, oh, George, this is really such a simple idea. And I thought, oh, this, her design wasn't simple at all. It was so amazing. Like she made that thing is, I think with George in particular, she can make really complicated, really ambitious designs seem quite simple because she just smashes it out.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting with George, and I think it's something that she shows later on as well, is that because of her skill set being so evolved, she's able to realise those ideas a lot easier than some of the others because she is so capable. And I think this is an example of, you know, taking a money box, a piggy bank. She didn't think of like doing a house. She thought of doing a whole Ferris wheel, which is great.
She's amazing. Yeah, her mastery of so many techniques and materials is just mind-blowing. And she does make it look simple and easy, but I know it's not. And that was beautiful, I loved it.
Yeah, but then we have the mastercraft, which is to now create a whole dream room. And so everybody has created these large-scale ideas. What did you think of everybody's work?
Well, they were all wonderful and so different. I did agree that George should have won. You know, it was a worthy winner.
Yeah.
But I actually really loved Jax.
Yes. I did too.
It was so much fun. It was so well done. I love it when you see his architectural talents coming in.
Yes.
To play. And all the attention to detail and how tactile it was and how you could really get in there and play, but it also was entirely functional as somewhere that you would sleep.
Also, because now thinking about it, his was the only one where he moved the bed. Everybody had the bed still in the same sort of central position, but he actually made the most of the quote-unquote room and moved the beds somehow, which I actually realise is, I don't know, I like that thought process of transforming the thing instead of like, this is what I got and I'm gonna arrange everything around it.
Yeah. Well, yeah, he really probably had the most transformative effect on the room, didn't he? But everyone's was gorgeous. I loved the dreaminess of Rosalie's. Mm. I loved the idea of going to that little cocoon and telling, reading stories to children was really adorable.
Yeah.
George's was so wonderful. I loved those lights, the reed lights
yes.
in the bedhead.
Yes.
She's just so bloody clever. And Rahana's space was also really dreamy and beautiful. Like it was sort of a little bit of a Victoriana feel and very dreamy and you know, even though unfortunately she didn't make it through, I still thought it was a really gorgeous gorgeous room and she should feel really proud of it.
Though, I can't think of anything worse than laying in a bed and having a fan just constantly blowing on me. I would feel so dry. Just like, oh, like, especially in summer. Do you ever feel that?
Yeah, actually, when Benja got in there and he said, oh, I could meditate in there. And I thought, I don't know if I could meditate with a fan blowing in my face.
No. Oh, oh, I just can't think of anything worse. Like, that's why you need the fan oscillating. Like, just this fan just constantly blowing on me. I just feel like I'd be the driest person. And so now we're going into our final three, into the finale next week. Who do you think has the best chance of winning the competition?
Look, I mean, I don't know. If we go by who's won the most challenges, maybe George? Has she won the most?
I think her and Rizaldi have now, I think with her to this episode, she's now tied it up with Rizaldi.
Right. I'm kind of thinking George might win because I just feel like she's like the best all-rounder maybe, but you know, having said that, I'm in love with Jack's ideas and I love it when he gets architectural.
Yeah.
And then of course you have Rizaldi, who's like this very deep, beautiful man. You know, he can just blow you away with what he comes up with. So don't ask me to pick one.
Yeah. Oh, what fully. Do you think? You could be anybody, literally, at this point.
Yeah. I'm so excited. I can't wait for next week. It's been an amazing adventure. Mm-hmm. Bring it on.
Well, thank you for joining me for this episode was actually very fun.
Thank you so much for having me, Chili Philly. No, and I can't wait to squeeze you IRL.
And thank you everybody for tuning into this episode of The Crafter Show. Join me again next week for the finale. And until then, keep crafting.